everyone, Miss Carrie here from Miss Carrie's Creations. Today I have some Easter tags for you that I created using some items from my stash. Our creative design team has been busting through our stash all month long with our Love Your Stash Challenge. This week's theme is wildcard, which means you can use anything from your stash to create something new. Today, I am going to be creating a project using these Christmas tags. I missed out on creating them during Christmas time. Some of you may be in the same boat. You may have purchased them at Christmas and you just didn't have time to make them. Today's video is full of items from my stash. We are going to be in Cricut Design Space designing items that we're going to cut from HTV iron-on. You're going to learn how to apply it onto the tags. I'm going to be digging out some paint from my home decor stash, some more embellishments, and of course these tags. So let's go ahead and get started with the project. I'm going to start out by painting two of the tags in a charcoal color. So I'm going to be mixing a reinker with some paints. When I want a full coverage color, I use this white paint by Delusions. Today I want more of a stained color or a chalk look, so I'm going to be using this white paint. It's found at Michael's. They come in small tubes, which is nice if you don't use a lot of paint all of the time. It's been a while since I've used this, so the tip is clogged. I'm just going to go ahead and grab my poker tool here, remove that dried paint, and then I can add a little bit of paint into this dish so I can mix in some of that reinker. So now that I have enough paint in the bowl, I'm going to add about 10 drops of reinker. These reinkers are for our Close to My Heart stamp pads. They are water-based, so you're going to want to use a water-based paint to mix the reinker in. Also be aware that the more reinker you add, the thinner your paint is going to become. I'm going to apply this paint onto the wood tag with a foam brush. I'm just going to add a light coat across the tag, and then I'm going to grab a little tack cloth here and wipe the paint to create more of a stain-like look. If I want a darker color, I can add a second coat of paint, or I can just let this dry and have that beautiful faded look. If we take a look at this tag up close, you can see that wood grain coming through and we have a nice soft shade of gray. Off camera, I'm going to go paint the other tag and set these aside to dry. These tags are going to be decorated with some wooden beads that I'm painting white. You could try to use a paintbrush, but I plan on showing you the most efficient way and an easy way that I paint beads. I've placed some of that white paint into a glass jar. Off camera, I'm going to go add some water, and then I'm going to mix these two together. This will thin down that paint so that I have more of a stained look on the wooden beads and not a full coverage of white paint. Once the paint has been mixed, you can pour the beads right into the jar. Try to avoid doing what I did here. You do not want that silica packet in with the beads. We can go ahead and just tighten that lid onto the jar and start shaking and rolling it to coat all of those beads. So I'm going to set this aside and let that wood soak up the paint while we go into Cricut Design Space and start making all of our cuts for these tags. If you purchase these tags from Close to My Heart, you received a free SVG file to help you cut out the tag images. We're going to have to upload those into Cricut Design Space. If you haven't done so already, you're going to need to download those SVG files to the device you're going to be using. I'm going to first sign in to my account. All of the digital files that I have purchased are in my account. All I need to do is click that down arrow under my name and click on the word account. We want the digital library. The digital library has all of the SVGs that came with any bundles you purchased, and it has the SVGs you purchased in our digital collections. I'm going to be using the plain tags that don't have any cutouts. So I need to click that download button in Windows. The download shows up in the lower left-hand corner. I'm going to go ahead and click that up arrow and open it up in the folder. Once I have opened it up in the folder, I need to extract it. This is a zipped or compressed folder, and you can't open those up in Cricut Design Space. So I've just right-clicked my mouse. I'm going to click Extract All, and it's going to extract it back into the Downloads folder. The biggest thing you need to pay attention to at this point is where this folder is at. Mine is in my Downloads, but depending on your device, it might end up somewhere else. Now we can go ahead and exit out of this window and go back to Cricut Design Space. We need to upload those tag images into Cricut Design Space. So I've gone over to Upload. I'm going to select Upload Images, then Browse. This is where you need to remember where that file is. Mine is in my Downloads folder. I'm going to double click that Tags folder so that it opens up, and I'm going to click on that tags SVG file. Here we can see that all of the tags are right there. You do have the option to give the image a name and tag it. Now I'm going to go ahead and click upload. Then I'm going to click on that image with the tags so that there's a little green outline around it, and I'm going to insert it into my canvas. Now we have all four tag shapes that are sized perfectly to fit our wooden tags. I'm going to ungroup them so that I can design each one of these tags separately. Two of the tags are going to be our gray tags. I'm simply changing the color to gray to give me a visual reference as I'm designing the images I'm going to be putting on the tags. The other two tags are going to be cut out of paper. So I'm going to change the color to the color of the paper I'll be cutting. For one of my bunny images, I'm going to go grab this bunny banner SVG from my digital download library. Once I have uploaded that, just like I did the tags, I'm going to go ahead and insert it right there into my canvas. I just need to use the contour tool to remove the two little holes in that bunny banner image, then duplicate it a couple of times and resize it to fit the tag. I'm also going to be adding some iron-on text to the bottom of this tag. So I'm going to go ahead and type in, "Hanging with my peeps." I'm going to choose a font for my text. I will put a link to this font down in the description below. Now I'm just going to use a couple of different tools and align and arrange and resize that text. On the second tag, I just need a bunny image. So I'm going to go into my image library, and I have found this card from our Artfully Sent collection. I'm going to be using the bunny cutout for my tag. I'm going to use the contour tool to get rid of everything except for that bunny image. And then I'm going to place that bunny image onto my tag and resize it. So we have one more tag that I'm going to add a few images to. It is going to be one of the tags that has the paper cutout. I'm going to be duplicating this bunny image multiple times so that I can cut it out to create a thick cardstock bunny image. The top layer is going to be cut out of patterned paper, so it will be shaded a different shade of pink. The last step is to add some text and click Make It. So now all of these tags are designed. Before we cut them out, I am going to hide the two gray layers. These represent those stained wood tags. They are not going to be cut out. When I got to the map preview page, I realized that the hole was separate from the tag. So I need to go back and select those tag images. Then I need to choose attach so that these two images are attached together and the circle cuts out from the tag. All right, so now we can go ahead and click make it again and start cutting out each one of our materials. All of the images that are being cut out of iron-on or HTV vinyl do need to be mirrored. So make sure you go through each one of those mats and click that little toggle button that says mirror. So at this point, we are going to be choosing each one of our materials for each one of the cuts. If you have a maker, you just set the base material by clicking Browse All Materials. If you have an Explore machine, you're going to turn the dial to either custom materials or to the specific material you are cutting. Personally, on my Explore, I just keep it set at custom materials and then use this Browse All Materials feature. As you cut out each of the materials, make sure that you are changing that base material setting. You're going to want to switch between the everyday iron-on to patterned iron-on to light cardstock to medium weight cardstock, all based on whatever material you are using. So just don't forget to change that as you are rotating through each one of your cutting mats. Now that everything's cut out, let's continue with the project. I want my tags to have a distressed look, so I've grabbed this file that I use for all of my home decor projects, and I'm filing the paint off along the edges of the tag. I'm removing a little bit more paint along some of the corners and the edges just to give it that aged look. I'm going to do this to both of those gray wooden tags. Now that the two stained tag bases are complete, I'm going to focus on the two wooden tags that need the paper cutouts. These are the paper cutouts that we just cut out using our Cricut. I'm going to use my tumble glue and use it to adhere the paper down. Many people struggle with wrinkles when they do this Mod Podge technique. I have found that an old brush and a brayer come in handy. I use the brush to make sure that the glue is applied evenly across the wooden surface. Next, I place that pattern paper cutout on top of the wooden tag, and I make sure that it is perfectly square over my shape. Now I'm just going to run my Cricut brayer across the top of the paper. You're going to want to make sure that it does not shift like it did for me here. I usually run the brayer across the front and the back of the wooden piece just to make sure that all of the excess glue oozes out the sides and the paper has a nice even surface with no wrinkles. When I started to assemble the second tag, I realized that there is a right and a wrong side to matching up the paper to that wood piece. One of them is off by just a hair, so you're going to want to make sure you have the right side selected before you add the glue. I'm going to repeat the same process with the second tag, adding that layer of glue with the brush and then using the brayer to make sure that the paper is nice and flush against the surface of that wooden tag. I'm going to let these tags set up and dry before I add that iron-on vinyl. While I'm waiting, I'm going to adhere all of those bunny layers together. I cut quite a few of these cardstock bunny layers so that I could form an image that is about 1/16 of an inch thick. This is going to work much better than using foam tape to give me dimension on the front of that tag. After I add each layer of cardstock, I do run the brayer over that bunny image. This just helps to spread the glue into all of the parts evenly and prevents any bubbles from occurring. I'm going to go ahead and skip ahead here to the top layer. After that top layer is added, you can see how thick this cardstock bunny ends up being. Now I'm just going to adhere the pattern paper down onto the front of the bunny, making sure it's nice and lined up with all of those cardstock layers, and I'm going to set this aside to dry. Our next step in the project is to add all of the iron-on vinyl onto the front of these tags. I need to start by weeding or removing the unwanted vinyl from all of the backing sheets. This is easily done using a weeding tool or a pair of tweezers or even a dental hook. I did speed up this part of the video quite a bit and skipped a few parts. I wanted to make sure that you saw the small bunnies. I did not cut them out of pastel vinyl. I ended up cutting them out of patterned vinyl that's all the same color to match my home decor. At this point, I realized that I had not dumped the beads out of the paint. I've actually left them in a little bit too long, and the paint's starting to dry and get a little bit chunky. So I'm going to pull all of these out of the jar, and then I'm just going to kind of rub them with a wet paper towel and set them aside to dry. All right, back to the task at hand. I'm going to be adding these pieces to the tags using my Easy Press Mini. I need to get onto the Cricut heat guide so that I can see what settings I need to set the Easy Press at for the iron-on vinyl and wood. I'm going to select Easy Press Mini. My heat transfer material is patterned iron-on and everyday iron-on, so I'm going to check both of them. My base material is wood. I'm going to hit apply, and it says to set it at medium and heat it for 40 seconds with a warm peel. I'm also going to check the heat settings for patterned iron-on vinyl. So I'm going to go back up to the top, choose patterned iron-on, base material wood, and the setting is for 30 seconds. So I'm going to do the everyday iron-on first so that I don't overheat the patterned iron-on. The EasyPress Mini has three settings, low, medium, and high. You just press the button for each one of the settings. While it is orange, that means it is heating up. Once it's heated, it will turn green and it will beep. I have already wiped down my wooden tags with a tack cloth. I'm going to place each one of these images down onto the tags and use some heat-resistant tape to hold them in place. This just prevents them from wiggling around when I'm heating them with that little easy press. I'm going to be using the same settings on that wood grain paper tag. I've placed the bunny down to help me with the placement of the word spring. My easy press is done heating up. I'm at the medium setting. Now I can go ahead and set my timer and start adhering each one of these images down onto the wood grain. You're going to move that mini press on the image as you're heating it for the 30 seconds. Be careful that the image does not shift while you're heating it, or it will cause damage to the iron-on. You're going to let each of these images cool for just a little bit. We are doing a warm peel, so they just need to be cool to the touch. After the backing sheet has been peeled off, you can see that each one of these tags looks like the images have been painted on. This iron-on is just a fun little addition to add to any of your wooden projects. I almost forgot about those patterned iron-on bunnies. So I made a little bit of a mistake here. I should have made sure the tape was at the top and the bottom of the bunnies. Unfortunately, because I did not have them adhered down well, they did shift a little bit. So when you take a look at this tag up close, you can see that the plaid is a little bit wonky, but unless you knew what it was supposed to look like, you would never know that I made that mistake. We have done so much with these tags so far, but I still want to add a couple of embellishments to each one. We're going to do this really quickly, so if you have any questions, go ahead and post them in the comments below. On this first wooden tag, I'm going to wrap some blue string around the bunny's neck, but I decided that I wanted a tiny little tag that I could stamp tied onto that string. I found one of my older stamp sets and there was the word bloom. So I grabbed my intense black ink and stamped that word right there onto that tiny little tag. I used some of my sapphire thread, wrapped it around the bunny's neck, then strung it through the hole in the tag, attached the tag to the bunny using a little bit of foam tape, and then I tied that sapphire thread into a bow. On top of the bow, I added a little paper flower. I used these in one of my Love Your Stash layouts. I happen to have a lot of these. So the little flower goes right there on the bow, and then I grabbed a flower sequence and added it on top of the paper flower. For some additional color, I attached a bluebell pearl in the center of the flowers. The last step was to adhere that cardstock bunny onto the front of the tag, trim the sapphire strings, and this tag is complete. I kept the Peeps tag pretty simple. I found these round polka dot cork shapes, and I added them onto the faces of each one of those bunnies. The third tag is going to be decorated with some wood shapes from my stash. Most of these are current items, but a few of them are from our fall catalog. After layering those wood shapes onto the tag, I grabbed a couple of cork flowers and placed them on the tag around and under the wooden shapes. To add a little bit of texture to this tag, I am looping some jute twine. I'm going to adhere the center of the twine together using a little glue dot. Then I'm going to place this bundle of jute under the large flower. The last piece is that little center flower, which I'm going to just glue right there on top. And then just for fun, I'm going to fray the ends of that jute twine. At this point, I felt like the tag was a little incomplete, so I might be adding a few elements to it later. This last tag has a few unconventional items on it. The collar around the bunny has been created using a metal photo tab, and it is adhered onto the bunny's neck. The hole on the photo tab is being covered with a metal flower. And then I just added a felt flower down in the corner from one of my embellishment collections. Most of these tags have a vintage feel, so I've decided to add some of these prong circles into the holes of the tags. If you're like me, you have a lot of these stashed in your craft room. To attach them to the tags, run a little liquid glue around the centers of the holes, insert the prong circles, and set them aside for a few hours to dry. So the last part of this video, I debated leaving off because we have packed so much into this project, but I knew you would want to know how to add the beads and tassels to your tags. This is really simple to do. You string your jute or your twine through the tag. I tied a knot at the top of each of the tags just to make sure that that twine was nice and secure. Then I strung each one of the beads onto the twine. I tied another knot at the end of all of the beads just to make sure that they were nice and secure before I added the tassel. To create the tassel, I wrapped some twine around a stamp set about 12 times. I slid those loops off of the stamp set, and then I tied a knot around the top of the loops. You want to make sure this knot is nice and secure so that the tassel doesn't fall off the end of your tag. I trimmed off the excess cord at the base of the beads, and then I cut the ends of my tassel so that all of the strands were even. Isn't this tag absolutely adorable? It would look so cute on a couple of those tiered trays. On the second tag, I strung some white beads on jute twine. Then I created a decorative gray bow to place at the top of the tag. I adhered this onto the tag with a glue dot. I created a tassel just like the first one. This one has some ribbon added. It has been tied around the top of the tassel and decorated with a metal button. The third bunny tag has much larger beads which have not been painted, a blue and white tassel, and a blue organza bow at the top of the tag. I wanted a large blue element at the top of the tassel, so I added a blue button which has been threaded with white thread and glued at the top of the tassel. There were a lot of elements added to these tags, but they are all just so darling, and they were so much fun to make, and I just really hope they inspired you to make a few things for your home. These tags allowed me to use so many items from my stash: HTV iron-on, metal embellishments, flowers, ribbon, twine, even some stamp sets I haven't touched in years. And to think, it all started out with those wooden tags I had left over from the holidays. I hope today's projects inspired you to use some of the stash in your craft room. Make sure that you check out all of the Creative Design Team Wildcard Creations this week by visiting each one of their channels. If you missed any of our past Creative Design Team creations, you can click on that collection icon above. While you're at it, go ahead and click that subscribe button so that you don't miss out on our March video collab. I hope you have a wonderful week. I can't wait to see what you create.